Hi, welcome to Numerix video blog, your expert source for derivative trends and topics. I'm your host, Jim Jockel. In a current interest rate environment, especially in Europe and Japan, we're seeing deposit rates below zero and market rates in negative territory. As a result, financial institutions are finding themselves challenged on many fronts, in particular in terms of their option pricing models. As this is becoming critically important, joining me today to discuss this is Alexander Antonov, Senior Vice President of Quantitative Research at Numerix. Welcome, Alexander.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you. So, question, when dealing with things like negative strikes and forwards for short maturity caps and swaptions, how does the negative rate issue impact the volatility surfaces?
Well, actually, the impact is twofold. The first thing is that we should change the quotation of the swaptions. The second thing, we should change the interpolation. So the first issue is not that complicated, technically not that complicated. Instead of making the quotation in terms of log normal volatility, which we all get used to when the rates were positive, we should address some option quotations if we have zero strikes, because negative strikes doesn't work for the log normal volatility, Black Scholes volatility. There are three ways to do that. The first is to quote option prices themselves, just in dollar value. The second one is to pick up the normal volatility, which is always valid even for negative strikes. The third thing is to use the shifted log normal volatility. Sometimes people do the shifted log normal volatility with a fixed shift. So the shift, for example, for no days for Swiss franc is 2%. So we expect the rates to be up to minus 2%. So as I said, it is not a very complicated thing. It's just variation around the Black-Scholes and Pascherly formula, but technically it's quite easy. The second thing, the interpolation that changes from the interpolation is more complicated. The thing is that our usual interpolation tool, the classical SABR model, doesn't interpolate the strikes to the negative values. It is, moreover, it behaves quite bad for small strikes. So if your strike is small, we can get some very non-arbitrage free solutions. For example, the density function can be negative, which is impossible. So people now, to address these complications, start to use the shifted SABR model for this interpolation.
So, in terms of a solution, there are many qualities people look for in forward rate models to fit the market quotes, but it's not exclusive. So, is the market starting to see the shifted SABR approach as being a best practice?
Markets does it because it doesn't have other choice. Actually, this shifted SABR model is not that good because we have everything is based on the manual selection of this shift. So it is non-calibrated parameter in the volatility interpolation. So it's not really clear how to choose it. We can of course pick up the shift from the volatility surface quotes, but it's not the best solution. So actually, there are a lot of drawbacks for this shifted SABR model. The first is the danger of non-smooth behavior of the parameters when the shift changes. Because imagine tomorrow the rates are even more negative, or for example they become positive. So we should which stays the same for several months. So this change will force us to recalibrate the model, to change the parameter. As a consequence, it will change. It will make a introduce a jump into the model prices, into the Greeks, and to the risk and everything. So as far as the volatility swaption is a very, very low basic stone for the pricing of the options, any instrument, almost any instrument will depend on that. So the whole book will jump. So it's not really well appreciated on that market, of course. Less important drawback is that the swaption prices are limited from above due to the limitation of the strike from below. So it is a danger that the shifted SABR cannot attain market prices near the shift position.
So how does this compare to the free boundary SABR approach that you and your colleagues have proposed?
Our free SABR model is much more natural extrapolation, I would say, of the classical SABR model. We actually do the following. Imagine we have classical SABR model, and when a scenario or Monte Carlo path touches the zero, we absorb it, we set it to zero. So that is why we call this absorbing boundary SABR. In our free boundary SABR model, we let the scenario or the path crossing the zero boundary, so without any absorption or other things. Now, it is a more natural implementation in the sense of that we don't have another shifted another parameter as a shift which not calibrate. Moreover, this free SABR has the same behavior of the initial as the initial SABR model for small times around the at the money also. So it fits quite well. Our habits, our trader. So the parameters of this free boundary SABR were not that far from what we get used to with the initial the classical SABR. However, this free SABR will go to negative values without any problems, and it has quite smooth dependence. I would say that the free boundary SABR has a nice analytical solution, which we also proposed in our paper. So for the calibration, it's quite important to have this nice solution for zero correlation and a very nice approximation for non-zero correlation, which permits us, the fast calibration with the same number of parameters with respect to the initial SABR. So everything is just very good.
Well, Alexander, thank you so much for sharing that. And for those interested, Alexander's paper is available on numerix.com, and you can go there and get that on via download. So, Alexander, we're going to be closely monitoring the negative rate issue, and hopefully you'll join us again on the video blog as this issue continues to evolve.
Thank you.
And for those who want to stay in touch with us, please feel free to follow us on LinkedIn or on Twitter at NX Analytics, and check back regularly for new news, blogs, videos, research, as well as technical papers. Thank you so much for joining.